look back and remember, we think of the world waiting for hundreds of years while God was silent. We think of that silence being ended, not by the cry of a prophet, the proclamation of a high priest, or the writings of a scribe. It is the simple statement of an angel to a young Jewish maiden. You are highly favored. You will have a son. You are to call him Jesus. The scene changes. We are transported to the hills near Bethlehem, and once again an angel appears. Don't be afraid, he says to the shepherds. I bring good news to you and to all people. Today in David's city, a Savior has been born. He is the Messiah, Christ the Lord. These men have heard thunder roll across those hills. They've seen lightning streak through the darkness and turn midnight into day. But nothing they have ever witnessed has prepared them for what happens next. Now the sky explodes with light and movement and sound. The shepherds who have been terrified by one angel behold a heavenly host, and all of them are giving praise to the Almighty. Glory to God in the highest, they shout. The praise is magnified 1,000 times over. Now a beautiful echo joins the chorus, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests.
Thank you.
song to sing because God has sent a Savior to the world. This glorious news caused angels to fill the skies with praise and sent shepherds searching through the night to find him. It's a proclamation that calls every believing heart to come and witness the miracle of Emmanuel, God with us.
Joy has come to the world.
Scene still brings us hope and peace after all these years.
Down where he lay, the little Lord.
Shepherds were the first to worship Jesus that night in the stable. His birth did not go unnoticed by everyone else. In a distant land, wealthy, educated men saw the star that announced his coming and recognized the sign. Something incredible had taken place. It became their mission to find him, to offer him treasure, and to worship at his feet.
Sky, wise men searching.
Bethlehem had been long and difficult. It had all ended with an urgent search for some kind of place where a young expectant mother could deliver her firstborn. To us, the story is filled with joy and wonder. We can only guess at the confusion and apprehension Mary experienced. Yet welcoming the child she knew as a miracle must have stirred in Mary's heart the same overwhelming love, the same hopes and dreams for her son that new mothers have always felt.
Mommies and daddies always believe that their little angels are special indeed, and you could grow up to be anything, but who would imagine a king? A shepherd or teacher is what you could be, or maybe a fisherman out on the sea. Carpenter building things, but who would imagine a king? It was so clear when the wise men arrived and the angels were singing your name, that the world would be different 'cause you were alive. That's when heaven stood still to proclaim.
One day an angel said quietly that soon bring something special to me, and of all of the wonderful gifts he could bring,
the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, in the stable that night, she saw men bow at his feet in worship. But the reality is that Mary didn't know all that we know. She didn't know the wonders he would perform, the people he would touch and heal and deliver, the way he would care for the poor and the outcast, the stories he would tell, the truth he would teach, or the sacrifice he would one day make. She held Jesus and she loved him. But there was so much about him that was beyond her comprehension. Trust him more, to be more like him. Today we know the story that took him to a cross, the story that left an empty tomb. He is our King and our Lord, and we worship him.
He became sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself.
today to come and meet the Messiah. Come to the manger and see him, God in the flesh. Hear the angels proclaim his birth. Watch the shepherds and the wise men worship him. Come and believe that he is the hope of the world. Discover the joy of Christmas, the joy that Jesus brings.